thank you very much, Scott. We do appreciate it. We are getting all outfitted right now.
We're getting organized.
Wayne, you need to get your jacket, and we need to get your gloves on.
So,
well, Wayne is gowning up because these are called PPE.
That's correct. Personal protective equipment.
Yes, which we've been hearing a lot about during the pandemic. This morning, we're welcoming back in studio our guest with a bang.
So happy to have company here.
We are so happy to be back.
Great Lakes Science Center is here with some super cool experiments for us.
Emily Schechter and Jill Dara Bradford are here this morning getting us ready for the 4th of July holiday with some safe bangs. Safe exposure.
Yes. Safe as long as you do it safely, right?
Exactly.
You can't do this at home, can you?
No.
Well, do you happen to have one of these at home?
Yeah.
I got one, but not that big.
Is it in your pantry at home? This is big. Okay.
Yes. So we're going to start off our show today with a little bit of a sparkler experiment here. So John Dar is going to pass. I'm going to have you stand over here. John Dar is going to pass around our sparklers. Now, the hallmark of any great fireworks show is the sparkler. It's a classic. Okay. So I'm going to have you guys hold out these magnesium wire strips. And I'm going to ignite it with this very large blowtorch. And what we are going to see is, I do have a fun job. Every day is so different than the last. Ready? We're going to ignite our brilliant, beautiful sparkler strips here. Can't forget my buddy Wayne.
And then it fell on me.
Oh, goodness.
Watch your toes.
Ta-da! TV magic.
Oh, my gloves are on fire.
Oh, no. I know. It's happening to me. Danger. Danger.
We have our magnesium wire sparklers. A little bit of fun for this morning.
Wait till
keep
like
you guys on your toes.
Okay.
Awesome. It's not the first time, I guess.
No worries.
So our next experiment is going to be another type of explosion. We are going to utilize. You're going to have to put on a little more protective equipment here.
Stand back, folks. We're about to do some science.
Don't try this at home.
Science.
I'd be surprised if you could. What we have inside each balloon is a mysterious salt. And that salt will change the color of the fire depending on its chemical makeup.
All right.
So we are going to have a little mystery fireworks show. I'm going to put this right at the edge here. There we go. And I'm going to give you guys, who wants to try it first?
I'll do it.
You want to try it first? Okay.
Sure.
She sounds so hesitant.
It's been a long year and 4 months, so
you got to trust me here. Okay, so what I'm going to have you do is hold this torch.
Okay.
I'm going to ignite it and light it for you, so it's going to stay lit.
Okay.
Just bring that flame right under the balloon.
Okay.
Ready?
Let's do this.
And...
There you go.
So we had strontium chloride in that one, and strontium chloride burns kind of a reddish orange. But the next balloon we have is a potassium chloride. So who feels lucky about potassium chloride?
I'll do it. What the heck?
Okay. All right. You guys sound so nervous this morning. I would never hurt you. Okay, are you ready, Wayne?
Don't hurt yourself.
Might just be career.
I'm not allowed to hurt the moneymaker. It's okay.
No, please go.
All right, ready? Same rules apply.
Just do it like this and just do it.
I'm going to have you hold it down right down there. All right, a little bit further.
Okay.
There you go. And I'm going to light it for you.
She's like saying back up.
We want this to explode on me. You got to bring it over to it.
Okay.
Ready? And woo! That is our potassium chloride.
Nice.
It burns kind of a yellow. Looks a little orange on camera.
Okay.
And our very last one.
Last but not least.
Last but not least.
I'm just hoping I don't ignite my hair.
Oh, goodness. Well, we won't let that happen.
I got a lot of hairspray
in
here.
All right.
Michael Jackson.
There we go. Okay, are you ready?
All right.
Our last fireworks show.
You know, I'm very klutzy. I don't know if I'd be trusting me with this.
That's right, I trust you.
Oh, my goodness gracious!
Yeah.
This is why we wear protective personal equipment.
It would have been my face.
Wow. You look wonderful.
What'd I tell you?
You forgot it.
All right, so we're going to do our last.
You get some singed.
Oh, just a little.
Yeah, it is a little singed.
It wouldn't be a Science Center segment if we didn't bring a little bit of fire.
Down. That's all that matters.
That's right, and you have this beautiful new studio. All right, so the final experiment I'm going to perform, and this one is a fireworks finale. And so for this one, definitely stand back.
You're okay.
Is this why Christy's so out today?
How far back do we need to stand?
Well, John Dar's going to make sure that you're
in the safety zone now.
Safety zone right here.
All right.
Christy. Oh, man, she's putting
the ear. I am putting the ear protection on because this one is loud. Okay. So you'll definitely want to make sure that you plug your ears.
Okay, plug your ears.
Here we go.
There we go.
Some help over there?
All right, ready?
Yeah.
We're ready.
And a one, and a two.
I got to get my lighter. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Be prepared.
I don't need any more loss of hearing.
Okay. I'm going to let the hydrogen inside of my rocket here. And as I'm doing that, all of the oxygen that's inside this container is going to start to flow out.
Okay.
And it's going to fill with hydrogen gas, which is very flammable. And John Dar, would you mind grabbing me a pair of fire gloves, please, my friend?
You want to use mine?
Yeah, I'd love
to. Fire gloves?
Here you go. They're slightly burned, but that's okay.
Right. That's all right. That's the name of the game.
One finger's missing, but it's
fine. Oh, no, no. Okay, I'm going to let go of this. Get ready.
Hold your ears.
Ready.
Okay.
Whatever John Dar does, we do.
Everybody has their ears plugged in the whole studio.
It's hard to make the flicky go.
Come on.
Uh-oh. Here we go. Here we go.
Are you ready? See? That's why we had you plug your ears.
That is our
Science Center fireworks show, and we are celebrating coming back to Fox 8 Studio with a bang, certainly, but we have a ton of stuff going on this summer. We're back 7 days a week, so make sure you check us out.
You guys are doing stuff outside for kids under the sun. Tell us about that.
So we are outside on the harbor 7 days a week, all summer long. Our themes rotate. Next month, we have a space theme, which is one of our personal favorite things to explore.
Yeah.
So there's so much all summer long. Things rotate. We have workshops. We have camps. There's just so much that we're doing this summer.
Good stuff.
Well, kids, unfortunately, have been watching all this stuff on Zoom in classrooms. They haven't been able to get their hands doing these things. So this is a great opportunity to just get them in and have so much fun.
And
discover science.
Absolutely.
And love it again.
It's fun to do it.
Science under the sun. We love it. Thank you guys so much for coming in.
We look like a singing group. You know,
we do.
We're in a band.
Yeah, we're
in my band.
So we have more information on all their fantastic programs on Fox8.com. Be sure you check them out because they have been staying busy, keeping your kids busy this summer. Gotta love it.